I'm a little bit nervous, so I want to excuse myself. Dobar dan. Good afternoon. Boa tarde.
Dobar dan. Two initial statements. We are very honored to be here with you. We feel like we are the best. We are the best in heritage. You are the best in heritage. You deserve a big applause. And this organization, it's the best in the world. We are the best in the world. Thank you very much. And the second statement, I lose my tablet yesterday. So our museum is from the Iron Age. So sorry, technology, sorry, nature. We must have the paper as a support. Dobar dan. The Metallurgical Eduardo Ferreira, MDF Museum, it's a local institution with national relevance, and we can say it now, an international presence. It belongs to the branch municipality. I'm a politician. I'm very proud to be a politician in a branch. Just in a branch, okay? And thanks to a partnership with the Tremagal Parish Council and Diorama, a private corporate group that owns the building, formerly the MDF's main office, in which the museum is housed, as well as a part of the museum's collection. Our land, Tremagal, it's like Portugal, it's like Portugal, Tremagal, it's easy to say it, Tremagal. Tremagal, it's a small town in the municipality of a branch. It stands by the river Tagus. It's over there, the river, in the heart of Portugal. If you go to Portugal, you may do a cross, and you are in a branch. Small as it thought, Tremagal has a particularity. Indeed, many of its inhabitants like to say, Tremagal was greater as a village than it's today as a town. A village that had a population of near 6,000 people, about 3,000 and a half today, who came there from everywhere in Portugal. Years ago, there was, in Tremagal, a health center with all medical specialties, including a maternity ward, a jazz orchestra, a brass band, two performance halls, football and athletic premises, schools filled with children from kindergarten to the secondary education, a shopping center, a countless small shops, and creations by major Portuguese architects. Such unusual high standards of life, which encompassed the work, cultural and economic fields, remains today mostly as a memory. But, there are always a but, their legacy lives on as a group of companies that install themselves in the former MDF premises. Curiously, their owners are once MDF workers. In fact, a whole open-air museum could be created there. All this due to the existence of a major company, a Portuguese metalworks empire that was based in the then village of Tremagal and turned it to a beacon of a progress during a large part of the 20th century. But, there was always a but, there was a big man behind the scene. Alicia?
I broke it.
Good. Like my tablet.
Sorry, thank you. The Metallurgica Duarte Ferreira Metalworks, began in Tremagal in 1879. Founded by a humble local, bootsman's son, who have dreams and ambitions and for his life, and was drawn for the forge's iron making fire. Eduardo was an entrepreneur, one quite ahead of his time. He was seen as a lunatic and maladjusted. Today, his memory is cherished and respected, and his legacy is an inspiration to all of us. The Metallurgica Duarte Ferreira was always different from other companies. It was a pioneer in many areas, such as the technological innovation in agriculture, machines, its original field of expertise, for it which Eduardo filed several dozens of patents. But the company also innovated in its organization and methods, as well as in its demanding quality standards. Notions that were completely new in Portugal, having been brought by Eduardo's children from other European countries and the USA, where they had studied. The Industrial Revolution only truly reached Portugal in the 20th century, and the Duarte Ferreira family contributed greatly to make that happen. That pioneering spirit also left its mark in social issues. All MDF workers, I made a parenthesis in here to explain this picture. This picture is the first 500 workers at the MDF company in 1925.
My great-grandfather.
It could be, yeah.
With the mustache like me.
So, as I say, all MDF workers had to at least be able to read and write. It should be noted that they began working at the age of 14. And the most of Portuguese people, most than 70%, are illiterated at the time. The company also created Portugal's first social security fund, giving its workers access to medical assistance, housing, culture, and sports. For decades, Tramagal was the only part of Portugal where it was possible to commemorate May Day. Since 1901, that date had been a time of celebration and conviviality between workers, employers, their families, and the rest of the community. The history of MDF is forever linked to Portuguese history, because the factory in the 60s produced a number of military trucks for the war opposed Portugal to some of the, his colonies, Angola, Mozambique, and Guinea-Bissau. The legendary Berliet Tramagal vehicles that left their imprint on thousands of lives. Not only in the lives of the more than 2,600 employees that worked at the MDF at the time, but mostly the lives of thousands of young Portuguese soldiers, many of whom attributed their safe return from the war to these, those trucks' robustness and reliability. The Butterfly Factory, thus nicknamed because of its trademark, Butterfly, okay, would close its doors in 1997 for a number of reasons that can only be comprehended if we look at the social and political context of the time. Still influenced by the changes brought about the 25 April 1974 revolution, which put an end to decades of dictatorial rule in Portugal. Still, excesses were committed in the revolution's wake, and that in combination with lack of experience, not surprising in a country that's been repressed for so long, caused a series of missteps to occur, bringing several large companies to an end. The butterfly. Why a butterfly has a trademark of a metal works? Well, that's the 1 million euros question. We are unfamiliar about the official reason behind that choice. But if we consider the life cycle of this winged creature and the company's history, the analogy is simply perfect.
Our home in Tramagal. At Tramagal. The MDF Museum is a small museum with a small budget. The building costs 400,000 euros, all hardware, software, and the buildings. 90,000 of them are made with UA funds, and the rest with our money, the municipality and the parish money. The MDF, it's a small museum, but it's another metamorphosis of the butterfly. When we ask MDF former workers what the company was to them, they all reply, it was a school. Their men and women are taught a trade and given a set of values that will guide them throughout their lives. These values inspire the workers and the whole community to preserve the company history and perpetuate its legacy. Here, a true spirit of place is experienced. The MDF Museum represents the fulfillment of an old dream and a wish of the Tramagal people, which originated a master thesis by Ligia Marx. This girl over here, who is present here today, and at the time a student, an unemployed student, but its proposal was made to turn this legacy into a museum. The Abranche Municipality and the Tramagal Parish Council believe in that proposal and decided to fulfill it. Thanks, Eulysia.
No, welcome. It's my pleasure.
What makes this project so unique is the fact that this perfect symbiosis of a specific and inspiring history with the will of a whole community in the communion with political decision makers who found merit in it, as well as the potential to generate cultural, education, and economic development. So, Ligia, it's now the best Portuguese museologist, one of the best. And they work with us. It's an honor.
Thank you. You embarrass me. Okay, thank you. The MDF Museum bases all its discourse on the new museology, whose main element is a narrative that leads visitors to empirically experience feelings and emotions, while the exhibits are accessories that complement the experience. It is a museum in the service of the community, of the people, for the people, and with the people. It intends to become a vehicle to local developments with the ambition of filling in the identity void left by the end of the company, developing a sense of belonging through the didactics of heritage.
We have a very small team. It's Ligia and himself and herself. And a few other people, three people that help her every day. But the MDF Museum, it's have a potential and ambition that are as big as the inspiration that found it in Tramagal. The butterfly continues to fly 140 years after its emergencies, though now it flies different. Following the master thesis of Ligia, detected as the museological basis for the museum creation, new works have been appeared. Several books have been written, one of which has received the EPOM, Portuguese Museological Society Merit Prize for research. Other projects including a documentary that passed into the museum by Glorybox here with us. Thank you, Paulo. Thank you, Paulo. Thank you, Felipe. An integrated educational service and artistic itineraries around the MDF's legacy in Tramagal, a variety of exhibition and conference and several partnerships with the most important Portuguese universities, which will certainly lead to much research and probably further master's and doctorate theses. Such academic partnerships are crucial to the museum's scientific development and critical mass. In our particular case, we believe they will lead to yet intangible new metamorphosis of the butterfly. Ligia?
Much forethought and attention to detail were lavished on the whole process that brought the MDF Museum into existence, respecting as much as possible the quality principles of the metallurgical Duarte Ferreira's legacy. Since the museum is housed in the premises of the company's former head office, much care was taken to preserve as much as possible the characteristics of that incomparable physical memory. For instance, the same type of metal originally produced by the factory was used to create the museological apparatus. The same principle of care and precision was also applied to the museological narrative, and as well as the conservation and restoration of the museum species, both in storage and on display. Always attentive to technological advancements, the museum also has an app operating in-house at the moment, but soon available to the general public, a number of online contents, and a certified online inventory program for the integrated management of our collections and audiovisual materials.
Much remains to be done. We want to be bigger and better. Our other projects in this area include the construction of three new museums. So, organization, best in heritage, we'll be back. Thank you. We are constructing a branch museums network currently underway. The consolidation of the Middle Tagus museums network and their integration into other similar networks, both in Portugal and abroad. The process so far has not been easy, but we believe that cultural policies will change. However, there is always a however. And as the tourism in Portugal, like in Croatia, grows exponentially, not even the honor of being awarded with the APOM Portuguese Museological Society, the best Portuguese museum prize at 2018, under the high patronage of the President of the Republic of Portuguese, was apparently suffice to make us eligible to receive financing from the Portuguese Tourism Board. But we will not give up. Somehow, we will get there.
In the guidelines for preparing our presentation included a question. What sort of advice could we give to anyone who wishes to set off on the adventure of museology? When I was writing my master thesis, my advisor told me often that I had to distance myself emotionally, thus allowing scientific thought, so desired in an academic dissertation, emerge. I was unable to do so. And that made my thesis different from the others. No better, no worse, just different. I'm sorry. Today, I know that the best advice I can give to all museologists or museum technicians is this. Feel. Be moved. Inspiring others to be moved. And by doing that, you will have a winning project in your hands and much easier and happier professional life.
The MDF Museum is precisely this. Like yours, you're my superwoman and superman, the child war museum. You are the greatest. I love you. It is a place filled with emotions. I'm a child war too. My father has been to the war in colonials, but then it doesn't matter now. It is a place filled with emotions, memories, and small but great details. Maybe also because of that, we keep receiving more and more tangible and intangible elements for our collection, brought by former workers or their relatives, which help us know this history better, helping us to fulfill our primordial task: preserving better, studying better, communicating better, perpetuating better. Can we saw a small video? Thank you. A meaning project does not spring by itself. Valorous peoples make it possible. In our museum reception is a dedication plaque that says, dedicated to all of those who made this history, and all of those who have worked on this long road. We wish to make this acknowledgement again here on this world stage. Thank you.
To the Duarte Ferreira family, to all the workers and their families, to all the people of Tramagal, to all the executives and technicians of a branch municipality and the Tramagal Parish Council, to the Diorama Group, to Patricia Fonseca, Paulo Monteiro, and the teams of Glory Box, to Paulo Passos, to APAM, to go our thanks for joining us in the dream of making the butterfly soar. Thank you, Rafala. Thank you so much to you as well. Thank you.
Thank you so much.